Hi friends, this is Calpur Piso. Be cat, brain is creating a thought. October 24th, 2014. You will never believe this, but of course this nurse from the ChristPsychosis infected Dallas Presbyterian Hospital that was infected by Ebola. Of course, now she is free of the disorder. And guess what? She thanks the power of prayer for being cured. Ignoring science. This is the problem with ChristPsychosis. This very ignorant lady doesn't realize that if she only prays and doesn't use the science of atheists, mentally healthy, in other words, atheist scientists, she would have been dead. But then, if she would have been dead, she could be thanking some bejesus. Because if they die, they will give life after death. Eternal life with some bejesus. Why are these ChristPsychosis infected idiots, deluded, stuck in the 12th century, that read only one book, the Bible? Why these people don't put their mouth where their faith is? They should rejoice if they die. They should welcome Ebola. They should be like the Islam psychotics in ISIS, that they don't care if they get killed, because they're going to be in heaven with the 72 virgins. So they go over there and attack the American crusaders, and they rejoice. If they get killed, oh wow, we got killed. So they don't care. They're not afraid of death like the ChristPsychosis idiots here are. And then they thank the power of prayer for being saved, ignoring science. They completely ignore science. That's what saved them. And they use for communication the internet technology, which is created by who? Scientists. Mentally healthy scientists. In other words, atheists. Who created the internet? An atheist. In about 1920 or something, Alan Turing, gay person in England. He developed this idea about the internet. An atheist, a mentally healthy atheist, and also a sinner because he was gay. He created the internet. So Christians, be true to your faith, psychosis. Quit using the internet because it's created by demons. By gay demons. But see what I mean? This is the problem, and nobody sees it. And the president welcomed this idiot nurse, this is a stupid psychotic nurse, infected with ChristPsychosis, that was saved from Ebola thanks to atheist scientists. He's welcomed in the White House. See the hypocrisy of this neural disease, the HIV of the neural array that nobody sees? Here are some clips. Truth, my friends, truth talks. Religious psychosis bullshit works.
The problem, the greatest problem in America that scientists don't seem to see, which is religious beliefs are a neurological disorder. It's like the HIV of the neural array that nobody seems to see. And to understand that, we must see and connect the dots on everything. And the most important thing in the United States is education. There are millions of churches infecting children with bizarre mathematical beliefs and concepts that are not true, false. And this is the problem. All churches keep the brain stagnated and dumb. And connecting the dots, you can see that here. It's obvious right here. academic fraud. Where is it at? Chapel Hill. Look at the name in North Carolina. What is the name of the city? Chapel Hill. It's all Christ-psychotic. See this? It's right there.
Like a gut punch.
There was an organization, a very complex organization that needed oversight at every step of the way, and it didn't exist.
Ford tracked the origin of the no-show paper classes to Debbie Crowder, a longtime assistant in the African and Afro-American Studies program, with a sorrow kept that practice going. And all the report finds, the paper classes went on for 18 years, ending in 2011. Interviews and emails confirmed. Counselors steered those athletes.
See? This is the reason United States, Christianity-infected United States of America, is the most dumb, ignorant, deluded Christian nation on the planet. They're stuck in the 12th century. This is the problem. They have millions of children. They are gun-trotting imbeciles. These people, they love guns. They start killing each other. They're stupid. They're extremely ignorant. And it's all due to what? Going to church. Believing all this resurrecting zombie that said with blood and all the Christian nonsense, which are delusions. They keep the brain stagnant. This is the problem. They read only one book, the Bible. And there are many Bibles, but they read only one. They believe all these 12th century mythologies to be reality. This is the problem. Just like in all religions, the Muslims do the same thing, the Islam psychotics, any Hindu psychotic, any religious psychotics have their own little sacred book full of mythologies. And they all believe that they are actually reality. They have no idea that the sick brains can only create sick thinking and reasoning. Nobody sees that. That's the problem. That is the reason of this.
And Prime Minister Stephen Harper laid flowers at a... You can see there that Ottawa remains a city that's on edge. Police say...
And religious psychosis does this.
And they were clear to stress that this incident was...
Lack of education, attending churches and mosques, synagogues all the time, and this is the problem. You're away from reality.
32-year-old Michael...
And you do this.
...a petty criminal and a Canadian-born Muslim convert. He was a teenager living in the West in particular to want to go overseas and join ISIS.
The United States, there are about 5 to 8 million Muslim Americans and Muslim Canadians. And so we're actually talking about a very...
Nobody mentions the religion. Nobody mentions the brain. No one.
Some kids get into drugs.
Idiot.
Some guys write poetry, and some people actually join
drugs,
organizations.
Poetry,
the fact is
ever.
We've only seen maybe a handful or a dozen...
He talks about everything, but he doesn't see the elephant in the room, which is religious psychosis. This is schizophrenia that nobody seems to see.
The fact that you've got three girls trying to get to Syria suggests that they are motivated by certain things, whether it's identity issues or a sense of adventure or a sense of romance. But it's
point because I think
sense of romance.
Just released a video.
I can see what I mean.
Stoned to death.
Oh, they all this stuff is motivated by everything except the religious psychosis that has been brought up with
the teenagers that we talked about.
Incredible.
These latest from Denver, teenage
Incredible.
Women wanting to go overseas maybe for some misguided sense of adventure, and then the region.
Misguided sense of adventure.
Are they
religious psychosis? They are ignorant. Education. Again, education. They have millions of churches in the United States of America teaching all this religious psychotic crap of zombies are resurrected and saved with blood, angels, demons, supernatural beings, and all this stuff. That's what it is. They teach all the supernatural mumbo jumbo nonsense, and they teach him all that crap. That's just the United States, the dumbest, the stupidest, the most deluded, Christianity-affected nation on the planet. Arrest my case. That's a fact, and that's the problem. The brain, and nobody mentions it.
And ISIS comes and says, everyone has betrayed you. Everyone, no one had helped you get a sense of your life. We want a sense of identity and a sense of purpose and a mission.
Religious psychosis, identity. Islam psychosis.
Situation. This is not
there you go. Stuck in the 12th century. Because they're dumb and stupid, the education has been the Bible, and they like the Quran a little bit better because they're going to get all these beautiful things in paradise and in heaven when they die. So they don't care about dying because they're going to be a better world. That is religious psychosis. Happens in all religious psychosis.
Islam to a glorious times, once upon a time that it was.
Yeah.
And with all religious psychosis come racism, homophobia, brain stagnation, definitely, pedophilia, irrational thinking, etc., intolerance. Look at this. And this is in the United States of America, a Christianity-infected nation.
And the problem that missionaries, see, like now, this lady in New York is talking about it. The CDC, look at this. The CDC talking about this missionary, you know, the, some of the missionaries that were saved. But now we have another one that is very intelligent, that actually is helping people. They're all atheists, just scientists, atheists, doctors without borders. They're trying to help people. One of them, you know, of course, got infected, which is really bad. But the problem is that people don't see that the worst disease, worse than Ebola, is the mental disorder, the dysfunction, the cancer of the brain, the religious virus, which is an HIV of the neural array. And people don't see that. See? And see this? This nurse, this Christ psychotic infected nurse, going over to meet President Obama. And she's thanking the power of prayer for saving her. Look at this thing. It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. It's incredible. And these people are, these Christ psychotic are running the country. There's going to be elections. And all these people in the Congress, these Christ psychotic infected imbeciles, running the country. Supreme Court has many of them. And these people belong in mental institutions. They should be repairing the brain of these psychos running the United States of America. And this disorder is spreading churches, keeping children theotarded, like I've been saying at nauseam. It is a fact, friends. And this is the problem. No power of prayer. Don't use medicines. You want the power of prayer to work for you? Don't use medicine, just pray. If you get Ebola, pray. If you get cancer, pray. If you get a toothache and an infection on your tooth, pray. Don't see a dentist. If you cannot see and you have suffered from all these problems, all these worms infecting your brain and virus and bacteria, pray. Don't use antibiotics if you get sick, pray. If you had a big headache and problems in your brain, pray. If you cannot smell correctly, pray. If you have a heart attack, pray. So why are these hypocrites doing this stuff? It's the power of prayer, the imbeciles, hypocrites. Power of science, that works.
Power of prayer, because I know so many people all over the world have been praying for me. I do not know how I can ever thank you, everyone, enough for their prayers and their expressions of concern, hope, and love. Prayer now for the recovery of others, including my colleague and friend, Amber Vinson, and Dr. Craig Spencer.
Amber Vinson, who of course is at Emory, and
the Craig power Spencer of prayer.
Bellevue.
Why this Christ psychotic infected idiot don't say the power of science? Why don't they pray? Don't use the medicines and the technology of science that cure her stupid ass.
The fire department.
This was incredible.
They sealed off the apartment and Bellevue.
This is incredible.
Certainly one of the.
It's another missionary idiot.
Know what it is doing.
There's been a real
this idiots benefit from science, and they all the power of prayer. Well, don't use medicines.
And how things were handled.
Don't use. Forget the medicines.
Really been done,
just
done.
Pray to your zombie God that you get cured and see what happens. See the power of prayer.
Public transportation.
Incredible the ignorance of these people, and the atheist scientists say nothing. They don't call these morons for what they are. They are Christ psychotic infected imbeciles, ignorant people, missionaries to boot.
I think we need
try to spread their zombie Jesus crap on everybody else instead of science and teach these kids the real science, not stuck in the 12th century. Power of prayer. Incredible.
Objects, you know, the virus.
This guy's a missionary. It's an idiot missionary.
For a day or two, and
and get spread to somebody. It's direct contact.
Well, don't say he prays so he doesn't spread the virus created by some bigot, isn't it?
Subway or being around the apartment living, those kinds of contacts. This is
what a hypocrite. If he believes in God and some in Jesus, why don't they pray? Don't use medicines. Don't benefit from the from science due to mentally healthy, in other words, an atheist brain. Why don't they use that? I mean, it's all the world is infected. Billions of churches in the United States of America, Christianity infected country, keeping people ignorant until Tartar stuck in the 12th century. This is the problem. This is the problem. ChristPsychosis.
Yes, the power of prayer. Where do they get this idea of the power of prayer from? Very simple. Churches. And they've been going on for 1700 years, controlling the education, controlling the government, controlling kingdoms, empire, for 1700 years. Remember that? Controlling the language, develop their own language. Because 2000 years ago, it was only Latin and Greek and some of the variation of the other local dialects of the vast Roman Empire. The official language was actually for the upper class was Greek, and then the Latin for all the masses. So that was imperative. But where did you get the education? ChristPsychosis, the church. And of course, later on in the 1500s, the Protestant church. All ChristPsychotics. And they control, they still with the psychosis today, in this 21st century. They have churches all over the place, universities, schools, all with the stupid education. Here in Phoenix, Arizona, look at this.
ChristPsychosis infection.
Look at this, ChristPsychotics. In this 21st century, the Catholic Church, prayers. Prayers for vocations. The Diocese of Phoenix. These are all ChristPsychotics. Look at this. All these people believe in imaginary friends. Look at that. All of them. They're stuck in the 12th century. These people get ordained. Priest. And they ordain and they do all this hocus pocus nonsense from the Roman Empire. That was okay, you know, 2,000 years ago, in the first, second, third century, because they had no idea about technology and science or anything like that in those days. But today we do. The brain is the creator of thought. We are product of coitus. There is no hocus pocus gods in the air that actually impregnate our mothers and all of a sudden there we are. No, it's penis Christ, is the organ of our dads that shoots sperm DNA, creating all these mutations, forming our brains, and then we emerge 9 months later. What is wrong with this idiot? And look at this. All these people are Catholic, Catholic means universal, ChristPsychotics. They believe all this nonsense to be true, all of them. And these people can be also lawyers and doctors and all that, but they're ChristPsychotics. They believe in the power of prayer. Well, don't be a hypocrite. Don't be a hypocrite. Be true to your faith. Do not use antibiotics, use medicine, don't use an operation created by mentally healthy, in other words, atheists, scientists, and intellectuals. No. Do not use that. Just pray. You get cancer, pray. You get a toothache, pray. You get a headache, and you suffer from all the coaching, and you're going to have dementia, and you have problems with your brain, you have a stroke, you can talk, go ahead, pray. Pray, see what happens. See, and this idiot, look at this. There are 1 billion ChristPsychotic infected imbeciles in the world. And guess what? All the Supreme Court, not all, 6 of them are Catholic. They believe in all this crap. Scalia, Roberts, and the rest of morons. They believe in this shit. And they are in the Supreme Court. And there's a lot of them in Congress. They're running the country, these lunatics. And atheists, intellectual scientists, and other mentally healthy, they say nothing. You don't see Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson complaining that these people are nuts. We should have scientists running the country, educated people with degrees, all mentally healthy, atheists running the country, being governors of a state, being judges, being doctors, medical scientists, and all that, all atheists. And this is the problem. You don't have them around this country. You have all these bunch of lunatics running the country. And everybody believes they're sane. Because believing in gods and imaginary friends is not linked to one of the schizophrenia psychopathy. It's the HIV of the neural array. And nobody sees that. And this is I blame atheists, scientists, for not speaking out. The American Atheist Association, they're clueless. American atheist organizations are clueless. They are like this, a tunnel vision. They had no idea. They don't connect the dots. And this is the gravest problem in this country.
About the election
coming up November 4th. I'm making this video talking about the Ebola nurse, idiot Christian. And then we have a shooting. Thanks to Christ. Nobody questioned the religion of this guy. Look at this.
And there's another initiative 594, that implements standardized background checks prior to any gun purchase, including private sales. Obviously, this is still unfolding, Jim, but we can't really have a conversation about school shootings without talking about the country's gun laws.
Well, that's right. It's going to come up. It always does when we have mass shootings. And there's some good ideas. The background checks, I think 99% of the country supports. And I think those are good things. When school shootings, what I've found over the years and working them, and also all the ones everybody's looked at, often is the gun comes from the home or a relative or a friend's relative. So usually it's a child can't buy a gun.
The power of prayer compels you. The power of prayer compels you. This guy is in school. If there is a guy with a gun, the power of prayer. In name, Jesus' name, drop your gun. Drop your gun. In Jesus' name, the bullets won't even hurt me. Power of prayer. See? United States is the most ignorant, deluded, Christ psychosis infected nation on the planet. Gun-trotting imbeciles, the new crusaders. And you know why? Because of education. It's all controlled by the Christian imbeciles. But these deluded people stuck in the 12th century. The country's control. The Senate, the Congress, the Supreme Court is controlled by these imbecile, psychotic idiots. They belong in a mental institution. They run the country. It's like having a pilot suffering from schizophrenia and drunk. Piloting 700 million people on a plane. Same thing. Nobody sees it. And I will keep going at it, and I will keep mentioning the facts. And atheists, they are clueless. American atheists are clueless. American scientists, atheists, are also clueless. They don't connect the dots, and they never call it for what it is and call these people running the country in positions of power that can destroy us, that can affect all our lives. And there's an election coming, and all these God-obsessed party are going to probably win the Senate. And this is what happened, anti-science imbeciles. And that's the reason why I get mad. But of course I can be quiet and, oh well, this is Calpun Piso, you know, let's, you know, to be acceptable, politically correct. I can be like the rest of the idiots, but I'm not. I get upset because it's an illness. It's an illness of the brain that nobody sees. This is the problem in this country.
Information that she could confirm, so we can't say with absolute certainty that any victims are here at this Everett Hospital. I'm standing across from the emergency room right now. I see a Marysville Fire Aid car.
And they are in a church. In a high school. But the power, blessed be Jesus. Oh, some be Jesus, blessed be. The shooter is in heaven with you. Praise the Lord, some be Jesus. The shooter is in there.
Oh, isn't it nice? And you use a tool from God, which is a gun, and the gun will transport you directly to heaven. All life. So everybody, all these other people there, all the Christians, should kill each other. They take a gun and shoot each other, and they, all of them will join the guy that was just ascended to heaven, into heaven. Praised be the Lord. The power of prayer compels you. Just follow the example. They should do that. And it's easier if all the churchgoers, the Christ psychotic infected imbeciles in the United States, they all should gather, all these people that go to church, should gather to the Grand Canyon. And then get on the edge of the Grand Canyon and say, in Jesus' name we jump. Yeah, just prove your faith. Get eternal life forever. The power of prayer compels you. As always, keep it healthy. I could not resist. Every time I see this psychosis of the mentally healthy, you know, there was an atheist like Dawkins, Terrorist, the science guy, Bill Nye. All these people are clueless, they are blind. They don't see that God believe or zombie God believe. I for fever, imagine I friend of four irrational belief acceptance found at the core of all neurological disorders and also all religions. It's like an HIV of the neural array. It's a form of schizophrenia, temporal lobe epilepsy, depression and all that, all combined into one. It's the malfunction of the brain that makes you believe in these things, accept this diluted concepts and things, which is faith, and faith is a psychosis, as if they were true. Keep them healthy, in other words, keep it an atheist. Educate yourself, learn, connect the dots. That's what I do. I connect all the dots and I see the disorder is infecting all the, in America, making America the most ignorant, deluded, immoral, homophobic nation on the planet. They're anti-science, they're idiots, and they run the country, and there are elections, and these psychotic people, schizophrenics, are religious Christians are allowed to vote. That's a problem. If you have a person that is schizophrenic and has suffered dementia, they are not allowed to vote. But see, they don't connect religious beliefs, apophobia, to a neurological disorder like a schizophrenia. So these people are loose in the street, they have churches all over the place, mosques, synagogues, and they do vote. They believe in imaginary friends. That is extremely dangerous. United States is going to go downhill. Our species will become extinct if we don't address this. Pace Deorum.